The tradition tells us that when our souls are being escorted to be with our Lord, that the angels are present singing the thrice holy hymn. So although Anthony is already here in the church, let's offer Aiosa Theos together. Ο Θεός ημών πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμμομίεν οδό, αλληλούια, ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Consumed with longing for your laws at all times. Alleluia.
Incline, my soul is weary with sorrow. Strengthen me with your words. Alleluia.
Possesses me because of the wicked who forsake your commandments. Alleluia.
Incline my heart toward your testimonies and not toward selfish gain. Alleluia.
Μέτοχος εγώ ημί πάντων των φεύγουμενων των φυλασσόντοτας έντολα σου. Αλληλούια.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen. Αλληλούια.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the rest of the soul of God's servant, Anthony, who has fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all his sins, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
May the Lord our God place his soul where the righteous rest. Let us ask for the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of his sins from Christ, our immortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Ότι σοι ανάστασης ζωής και ανάπαυσης του και κοιμημένου σου δούλου σου Αντωνίου Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπομεν συν το ανάρχο σου πατρί και το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι νυν και αγί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Εχείρε σου επίσαμε και πλάσαν με, συνετισόμε και μαθήσαμε τα σέντολα σου. Ελέησον με, Κύριε.
Become like a wineskin in the frost. I do not forget your commandments. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
I am yours. Save me, for I have sought your commandments. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
I have not departed from your commandments that you have taught me. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
I have inclined my heart to perform your commandments forever, and I await your mercies. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
It is time, O Lord, for you to act, for they have disregarded your commandments. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ελέησον με, Κύριε.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you, O Christ, our God, are the resurrection, the life, and the blessed repose of your servant Anthony, who has fallen asleep. And to you we offer up glory, together with your eternal Father and your all-holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Ελέησον με κατά το κρίμα των αγαπώντων τον όνομα σου. Αλληλούια.
I am young and despised, yet I do not forget your commandments. Αλληλούια.
Τις φωνείς μου άκουσον, Κύριε, κατά το ελεός σου, κατά το κρίμα σου ζήσον με. Αλληλούια.
Powerful people persecuted me without cause, yet my heart stands in awe of your words. Alleluia.
My soul shall live and praise you, and your commandment shall help me.
I have gone astray like a lost sheep. Seek out your servant, for I have not forgotten your commandments.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you, O Christ, the God of the resurrection, the life, and the rest of your servant Anthony, who has fallen asleep, and to you we offer up glory, together with your eternal Father, your holy and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου τον Αγίον ο χορός, έβρε πηγήν της ζωής σκέθηραν παραδείσου, ευρωκαγώ την οδόν δια της μετανοίας, το απόλολος πρόβατον εγώ ημί, ανακάλεσέ με, σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
For you, O Christ, our God, are the resurrection, the life, and the rest of your servant Anthony, who has fallen asleep. And to you we give glory together with your eternal Father, and your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O Lord. Teach me your commandments. Of old you created me from nothing, and honor me with your divine image. Having transgressed your commandments, you return me again to the earth from which I was taken. Restore me to the original beauty of your likeness.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you, O Christ, our God, are the resurrection, the life, and the rest of your departed servant Anthony, who has fallen asleep. And to you do we ascribe glory with your eternal Father and your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδοξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, εικόνιμη της αρήτου δόξη σου, ή και στίγματα φερόπτεσβάτων, εκτήρησον το σόν πλάσμα δέσποτα και καθάρισον σι εσπλαχνία και την ποθυνήν πατρίδα παράσκουμη παραδείσου πάλιν ποιόν πολίτην με.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου. Grant rest, O God, to your servant, and place him in paradise, where the choirs of the saints and the righteous, O Lord, shine like stars in heaven. Give rest to your servant, who has fallen asleep, overlooking all of his transgressions.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι, το τρίλαμπες της μίας θεότητος, ευσεβώς υμνησόμεν βόντες, Άγιος Υι, ο Πατήρ ο Άναρχος, ο Συνάναρχος Υιός και Θείον Πνεύμα, φώτισον ημάς φύσης η λατρεύοντας και του αιωνίου πυρός εξάπασον.
Now and forever and to the ages of ages. Amen. Hail, O pure one who bore God in the flesh for the salvation of all people. Through you, the human race has found its salvation. Through you may we find paradise, O Mother of God, pure and blessed.
Alleluia, 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 O Exaltio Theos. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 the Exaltio Theos.
With the saints, give rest, O Christ, to the soul of your servant, where there is no pain, nor sorrow, or sighing, but life everlasting.
Son Christe,
Of life remains unmixed with sorrow. What glory has stood unchanged? All things are more feeble than a shadow. All things are more deceitful than dreams. For in an instant, death replaces everything. In the light of your presence, O Christ, and in the sweetness of your beauty, give rest to him whom you have chosen from among us, for you love mankind.
As a flower withers and a dream vanishes, every person perishes. When the dead hear the trumpet sound like an earthquake, they will rise again to meet you, O Christ our God. Then, O Master, place the soul of your servant Anthony, whom you have chosen from among us, O Christ, in the dwelling of your saints.
The mystery of death is truly the most fearful. How the soul abruptly separated from its harmonious union with the body. How is this most natural bond severed by the divine will? Therefore we pray, give rest to your servant in the dwelling of your righteous, O giver of life, for you love of mankind.
I recall the prophet saying, I am earth and ashes. And again, I thought about those in the graves and I looked upon the bare bones and asked, who therefore is king or soldier, the rich or the poor, the righteous or the sinner? But give rest, O Lord, to the soul of your servant among the righteous, for you love mankind.
I recall the prophet saying, I am earth and ashes, and again I thought about those in the graves. Your creative command was my beginning and existence, for you willed to form my life out of visible and invisible nature. You created my body from the earth and gave me a soul by your divine and life-giving breath. Wherefore, O Christ, give rest to your servant in the land of the living and in the dwelling of the righteous.
Μετέσεις σας αδελφών ημών, εκ των προσκέρων κράζοντα δόξα σοι.
I lament and I mourn when I contemplate upon death and see our beauty created in the image of God now lying in the grave. Without any shape, any glory, or any form. Oh, how strange, what is this mystery concerning us? How were we given over to corruption and wedded to death? Truly God shall command, as it was written, to grant rest to those who have departed.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι, ο θάνατος σου Κύριε, Αθανασίας γέγονε πρόξενος, ημιγάρ εν μνήματι κατετέθης, ούκαν ο παράδεισος συνέοκτο, διό των μεταστάντα ανάπαυσον ως ηλάνθρωπον.
Now and forever and through the ages of ages, amen. O pure Virgin, the gateway of the Word, as the Mother of our God, pray for mercy on his soul.
Masisi
I call to you, the Lord my God.
Wisdom.
The lessons from the first epistle of Paul to the Thessalonians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, we would not have you ignorant concerning those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we, who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we shall also and always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words.
Peace be with you.
Peace be unto you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, arise. Let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be with you. All of you.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Let us be attentive.
Glory to you.
The Lord said to the Jews who came unto him, truly, truly, I say to you, he who hears my word and believes in him who sent me has eternal life. He does not come into judgment, but has passed from death to life. Truly, truly, I say to you, the hour is coming, and now is when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear it shall live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself, and has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming when all who are in the tomb shall hear his voice and come forth. Those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of judgment. I can do nothing on my own authority. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my own will, but the will of the Father who has sent me.
Kyrie doxasi.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the rest of the soul of God's servant, Anthony, who has fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all his sins, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
May the Lord our God place his soul where the righteous rest. Let us ask for the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of his sins from Christ our immortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, you trampled upon death and abolished the power of the devil and given life to your world. Give rest, O Lord, to your servant Tony, Anthony, who has fallen asleep in a place of light, in a place of comfort, in a place of refreshment, where there is no more pain, sorrow, or suffering. As a good and loving God, pardon every sin which they have committed, whether in word or deed or thought. For there is no person who lives and does not sin, except for you, the only sinless one. Your justice is eternal justice, and your word is truth.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you, O Christ, our God of the resurrection, the life, and the rest of your servant, Anthony, who has fallen asleep, and to you we offer glory with your eternal Father and your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
To Kyrie Theithomen. Ότι εσύ η Ανάσταση στη ζωή και η μακαρία ανάπαυσης του κεκοιμημένου δούλου σου Αντωνίου, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν, συν τον Άρχο σου Πατρί και το Παναγίο και Αγαθό και Ζωοποιό σου Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αιωνία σας ημνήμη άξιμη κάρισε και είμαστε αδερφέ ημών.
Eternal be your memory, our brother who are worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Αιωνία σου ημνήμη άξιμα κάρισε και αείμνηστε αδερφέ ημών.
Eternal be your memory, our brother, who is worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Eternal be your memory, our dear brother, worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Of Father Alexander, on behalf of Father Peter, on behalf of Father Peter Zugris from St. Demetrius, who was a young boy in Staten Island when Tony was there, on behalf of Father Alex Camilleris of St. Mark, on behalf of Deacon John, I greet you, the family, with much love and peace. We sang some beautiful hymns today that have much power and meaning. And I would think that these hymns really do stir something in us and help us prepare ourselves. And when I say prepare, I'll speak of preparation in just a moment. But these prayers are not just words, but they're meant to be powerful hymns and prayers that lift us up to something out of the ordinary, something beyond our lives here, something heavenly. Tony knew all about that. These hymns bring us joy, they bring us peace. One of these hymns, I am an image of your ineffable glory, though I bear the mark of transgressions. So think about if Tony himself was saying these words. He is an image of God's glory, but he knows he's a sinful man. Have mercy on your creation, O Master. Cleanse me by your love and grant me the desired homeland. In Greek, that word is patrida. But patrida is not about a place in Greece or a place in the Sudan or a place in Staten Island. It's a place in paradise. Again, a citizen of paradise. Something quite powerful, making me again a citizen of paradise. We are in this week of Holy Week. And I have to say, it's most fitting that this funeral is taking place now, because this man was here at every possible service you can imagine, and especially during Holy Week. And it's during Holy Week that we, first and foremost, the first few days, we experience the bridegroom service, which is the time that we await for the bridegroom, and we think about the second coming of Christ. And are we ready to be with the bridegroom, Christ? If he is the bridegroom, we are, and the church are the bride. So thus, we're walking together on this journey. We progress, and we follow his Christ's last days on earth. We follow the days then when he is lifted up and he is crucified on the cross. And of course, we know that on Friday then, we experience something beautiful. Christ descends into Hades, and he does something great. He does the same thing that he did here on earth. He preached, he taught, he forgave sins, all those things. He did so here. He's doing down there. And then on the third day, he rises again. And thus, you always have the crucifixion with the resurrection. In life, there is no glory without suffering. We always must prepare ourselves for that time. Preparation is key. Tony, and I had to write down some notes for him. Tony was a man who prepared his whole life. And I mean that honestly. Everything about him, with his little engineer hands, he prepared for the greatest things. He knew that life wasn't easy, but he had to prepare himself. From the Sudan to Italy, to Staten Island, to South Florida, he made his way. Truly, truly a beautiful journey. A devoted husband. He loved Marina with all of his heart, with all of his mind, with all of his body, everything that he could do. Whether he was taking you to an appointment or being there by your side or walking with you or playing biriba, whatever it is, he was there with you, loved you so much. His children, Corrine, Nestor, their spouses, and his grandchildren, he spoke of so often. He had a great love for his church. He used to tell me, "You're my spiritual father, but I also have another spiritual father, Father Nick Anktel." And he sends his love. And actually, Father Nick, I spoke to him this morning, and I asked him to offer a few words, and he wanted me to send this to you all. I said, tell me something about Tony that you want me to share. And he said, "Tony just had a special love and respect for the clergy in general. He wanted always to please us in whatever he could offer. When we came to Staten Island in 1989, Tony was one of the first to calm the waters of a very divided parish by reaching out to both sides to work together in support of their new priest following Father Macris's death." That new priest was Father Nick. "He would have made an amazing political leader. We will miss him terribly. All of our love to Marina, Corrine, Nestor, and the family." How true are these words, that he really was a man that wanted peace. He didn't like when people were fighting. He didn't like disruption. He wanted peace. A beautiful, beautiful thing. Tony was one of the first two people that I met here at St. Mark. When I was asked to come and visit, I walked in the doors, and it was Tony Nicolaides and one of his best friends, Pat Anthony. And the two of them said, "Are you going to be our new priest?" I said, no, I'm just here to visit." And it was so cute. But they're the first two people I met here. And he walked around that day and showed me everything in the church. If you can imagine when I say everything, every icon, the marble, he walked up, the chanter stand, the pews. "Let me tell you about the pews." And he would tell me the story. Then he would say, "Let me tell you about this." He knew everything in this church. Over time, he became a true confidant to myself, to all of the clergy. he had a servant's heart, not just in his church, not just in his home, I should say. Some people call it the second home is their church. For Tony, I like to just say his home was the church, because that's something very special. That man was here all the time. They don't make men like this anymore. He was a faithful parish council member, and thus you notice the parish council all were here to walk Tony into the church today. He was, forgive me, he was on our interior beautification committee. He helped with all of the icons in the church. He helped with the painting. He helped with the marble on the floor. He helped in every aspect. When it came time to create the bangaria in the back, Father Alexander needed someone trusted with him, and Tony was there by his side creating every last breath of it. Every little thing he never missed. He was on our growth and planning committee, one of our leaders with Tim. He used to come to every Bible study when I first came here, up until the last few years. He was an usher. And while he wasn't the head usher, can I tell you, he was the head usher. And he stood there in back of the church in the middle, and that's where Helen's pointing right now. He stood in the middle, and indeed, he did great things. He taught all of us how to be in church. He always did. He was a true servant. He even came to our Discover Orthodoxy classes. He did everything you can imagine. His pareja, when I first came here, and I'm looking out and seeing a few of you still, on Saturday nights, they had their Saturday night dinner, and they would all go out. And when my parents came, they invited my parents to be part of that, and that was indeed a blessing. He had his golf, the AHEPA, his Bariba card games that he played up till the night before he went into the hospital, which is truly amazing. But really, church was his home. He was awarded the Medal of St. Paul, which is the highest honor our archdiocese gives out. The Medal of St. Paul. And Archbishop Demetrius himself gave it to him right here from the royal gates. He was the go-to for all of us, for myself, the parish council, for Dawn in the office. I can't tell you how many times. Even this past year, we'd call and say, Marina, can we talk to Tony? Yes, what do you need? We need the plans. We need the blueprints. Where can we find them? I'll get them to you. Don't worry. And somehow he would appear with everything we needed. Some personal memories allow me to share of our beloved Tony. On Holy Saturday, before the resurrection, in the morning we'd have the liturgy. And that day, a few of us stay behind, the parish council, a few of us stay and we clean up and we get ready for the evening. Everyone would leave except Tony, and he would make sure that everything was ready for that evening. The red carpet in the back, the stand in the back. He would say, Papa, do you have the candle? I said, I got the candle, Tony. We would go through everything, and that was a very special moment. The candelia up on the altar, on the iconostasis, you see those candelia? He found a way to get them up there. I said, Tony, they're too high. I'm not going to be able to change the oil all the time. He goes, don't worry about it. I'll take care of it. He ordered them, he rewired them, and made them electric. And I said, but how are you going to get it to make it look like it's flickering? He goes, I'll take care of it. He got the bulb that did so. He's like, we're going to make it right. The consecration of our church was a magnificent event. It was a culmination of so much blood, sweat, and tears over the years that the St. Mark faithful worried and worked towards. Tony, with his black robe, was in the back of the altar, and he was chosen to prepare the miron, the myrrh that we do, and the special ointment that we anoint the table with, that the bishop takes then and does it. He was so proud. I still have the picture of him smiling back there with his big joy. And from that point on, he said, you know, I used to be an altar boy. And I said, you can come in the altar whenever you want. And he would come on weekdays with his black robe in the altar and help. The prophet Elijah icon over there for years suffered because of water damage. Tony actually took gold leaf and taught our wonderful custodian how to gold leaf, and he worked on that icon to make it so beautiful. There was something special. Tony was a member of the St. Marksmen. And we gathered about 4 months ago at a restaurant, about 35, 40 men of the church, men of God. And Tony came in, and we said to Tony, we want you to give a little talk to the marksmen. And he says, I got it. So we walked up, and you can imagine, in a loud restaurant, there was 40 men who gathered close, and we all huddled up. And it was loud, and things were going on. Tony came in the middle, and with his voice, we said, Tony, what do you want to tell these men? And he says, love the church and love God. It has never disappointed me in my life. Love the church and love God. That's your calling. That's all of our calling, to love the church and to love God. Tony did it par excellence. Tony did it on a level that we can all strive to be. Tony did it on a level that was something truly, truly unique. In his last days in the hospital, we gathered a few nights after he was in there, and he wasn't responding at all. And I spoke to George and Nestor, and we went there, and we said, let's say a prayer. Maria was there. We went in there, and we'd offered our prayers for Tony. And as soon as we gave him Holy Communion, it was as if a light switch went off. He went, Papa! And he was just smiling. And the joy that he had on his face. And then it continued. We anointed him. And then he started talking. It was as if he was giving us the final words. He was saying, you know, I got to get through, you know, Katsupas. You know, you got to tell Katsupas to do this. And then he said, and Gerard, we got to tell Gerard, he's got to fix that light up there. He's got to do that. And, you know, I got to tell Dawn. I got to tell Dawn to do that. We got to remind her. She's got so much going on. We got to remind her. It was truly amazing. In his last moments, when he just woke up from a coma or sleep, whatever it has been, his mind was on the church. To make sure, to prepare the church. We have to get it ready. He was indeed a man of God. In the final hours, Father Alex had the blessing to come with you all and to pray with you and to read the prayers of the separation of the soul and body. When Father Alex left there, he called me and said, the most beautiful experience I've had as a priest, to be there with the family, with our beloved Tony, reading the prayers, and offering our final goodbye. It was truly amazing. But that's how Tony was. Everyone who met him felt like they was his best friend. All of us here are here because we love Tony. We support Marina. We're here for Karina, for Nestor, the family, the grandchildren. But we're here because we love this man, because this man loved God and loved his church. He prepared himself in so many ways that I cannot even share them all. And I'll share with the family later a real personal thing that I'll say of how he was prepared. He prepared himself for the next life. My brothers and sisters, our job here is to work hard. Is to work hard and not just to think about the worldly cares, but to think about the heavenly things. Our job is to prepare ourselves for that moment when we will die. But in death, something great happens, because when Christ came, he took it all on, and thus he conquered death that we're going to celebrate this week. And by conquering death, he opened up a new life, which is paradise for all of us. Tony's patrida, our homeland. May our Lord give eternal rest to his beloved servant Tony, Anthony, Antonios, and may he rest with our Lord in his kingdom. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Prior to the service, many of you had the opportunity to offer your final goodbye to Tony and greet the family. We thank you for doing so. If you haven't done that yet, we don't want to put the family through that again. If you haven't had the opportunity to say your final goodbye and you would like to come forward, our parish council will usher, the Glick family funeral home will turn the body, Tony. And then afterwards, the family will come up for the final goodbyes. We'll go to the Boca Raton Cemetery for the interment, for the final resting place of our brother.
Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff will comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine and mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. He who dwells in the secret place of Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him I will trust. Surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowlers and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. He is true, and his truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor the destruction that lies waste of noonday. 1,000 may follow and fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes will you look and see the reward. The reward is way. All the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth to such as keep his covenant and his testimonies. For your name's sake, O Lord, pardon my iniquity, for it is great. Who is the man who fears the Lord? He and him shall he teach the way he chooses. He himself shall dwell in prosperity, and his descendants shall inherit the earth. The secret of the Lord is those who fear him, and he will show them his covenant. My eyes are forever toward the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. Turn yourself to me and have mercy on me, for I am desolate and afflicted. The troubles of my heart have enlarged. Bring me out of my distresses. Look on my affliction and my pain, and forgive all my sins. Consider my enemies, for they are many, and they hate me with cruel hatred. Keep my soul and deliver me. Let not me be ashamed, for I put my trust in you. Let integrity and uprightness preserve me, for I wait for you.
We anoint with oil. Oil is a symbol of forgiveness and a sign of new life. And we also take a little earth, and we, because we all were created in God's image from the earth, and from earth we all shall return. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be whiter than snow. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. From dust you came, from dust you shall return. Just stay here.
Aye, O Theos, aye, O Ischia.